1, boost ignition, and liftoff.
For half a century, we've been visiting the cosmos. This is a look at some of the missions and technologies we'll be pursuing in the next 50 years and beyond as we continue to explore the infinite space around us. In the short term, NASA's only committed to servicing and manning the International Space Station until 2024, so there's a good chance the project will be deorbited within the decade. Meanwhile, the Chinese are working toward building their own space station. So space is currently undergoing this transformation as companies begin to fulfill the relatively simple tasks of taking people, cargo, and satellites into orbit, while NASA has shifted its focus to much more difficult challenges, like capturing and mining asteroids and sending man to Mars. But many obstacles will need to be overcome before either mission becomes a reality, including protecting astronauts from exposure to high levels of radiation from the sun and getting people to and successfully landing on the red planet. So to get a sense for how researchers are imagining the future of space, let's take a look at the 15 projects NASA just funded with $100,000 grants. Superconducting systems that can stay 50 degrees Celsius cooler than their surroundings to allow for long-term cryogenic freezing. It's not for keeping Han Solo or astronauts like an Interstellar alive, it's to store large amounts of energy for the long distances necessary to reach deep space. Nanotechnology will make new satellites and space probes tiny and cheap. Highly concentrated energy beams could continuously power these tiny objects at ultra-high speeds away from Earth. These beams could also vaporize asteroids threatening our planet. Another idea is to launch many tiny CubeSats to bombard the surface of asteroids and comets to gather seismic readings that would reveal what's beneath their surfaces. Powerful radio waves shot out of quasars and pulsars act like a map and could guide an autopilot system for spacecraft venturing into deep space. Chemicals mined from asteroids could be used as fuel for spaceships. Another asteroid project would extract 100 tons of water by drilling into it with concentrated sunlight, a technique called optical mining, and then keep the frozen ice ball in Earth orbit for use in later manned missions. Then there's the Hopper, a rocket-powered vehicle that could explore Neptune's moon Triton, which only has 8% of Earth's gravity. It could hop off the surface and circle the moon in one bounce. Robots powered by wind and the magnetic fields of host planets could allow for the exploration of the atmospheres of Jupiter and Saturn. And Jupiter's shifting magnetic field could also power a squid-like rover that could even be submerged in the subsurface saltwater ocean on its moon Europa. Space-based telescopes with magnetic mirrors will allow them to move to correct for image distortion, a much more dynamic approach than today's generations of giant telescopes with fixed mirrors. Another effort aims to replace expensive, curved mirrors in space telescopes altogether by substituting them for an ultra-thin film that achieves the same effect at a fraction of the cost. Hives of tiny, inexpensive robots could swarm the coldest, dark sides of our moon to gather samples and then come together to heat them up and report back the data. Thirsty Walls is a complete reimagining of the air revitalization system to recycle air in a highly efficient way in microgravity so people can survive long-range missions. The oxygen supply problem is one of the main challenges in getting humans to Mars. Which project do you think most needs to succeed? Join the conversation with your thoughts in the comment below, and if you like this video, share it to help it spread. You can watch more TDC by clicking the video on the left for our breakdown of the imminent weaponization of space, or the video on the right to learn about 10 future energy sources that could power life on Earth into the next century. And if you want to learn a lot more about the ultimate frontier, we've arranged for you to get a free audio download of the new book Space Chronicles by the preeminent space communicator Neil deGrasse Tyson through the link below if you sign up for a free 30-day trial at audible.com. This has been a production of the two-man team at TDC, aka the Planck Brothers. We'll leave you with this thought from the great Carl Sagan. There is perhaps no better a demonstration of the folly of human conceits than this distant image of our tiny world.